Hello and welcome students. Today we are going to learn about vegetative propagation. Vegetative refers to the root, stem and leaves. When a plant uses any of these for reproduction, we call it as vegetative propagation. Normally you might have seen a grass, if it is planted somewhere, it starts to grow and we call it as the runner. Or if we take money plant, we just cut the stem and put it in the water or in the soil and it starts to grow. There are many plants like this where a piece of root or a piece of stem or a piece of leaf is enough for their regrowth or regeneration or reproduction. For roots, for stem or for leaves, you have heard about a potato, onion, mint or bryophyllum. Those are the common things. But sometimes some of the plants, even though they have flowers, they lose the ability to produce seeds. When they lose the ability to produce seed, man takes up the process of artificial vegetative propagation, so that we get that fruit or the food from that particular plant. The best example here is that of banana, which has lost the capacity to produce seeds, and so it has to be propagated artificially by man. Artificial here means done by man. The first one is cutting. This is commonly seen in rose plant. Though there are flowers, the rose plant is not able to reproduce using the flowers. The stem has to be cut and grown. Next comes layering. Some plants like jasmine, when they grow, one of their leaves, branch is brought down into the soil, and from here a new plant again grows. That is called as layering. Next we come to grafting. Grafting is when two varieties of plants have to be grown in the same variety. That means we need the best of two plants in one plant, then two plants are grown one above the other. The stem of one is planted on the stem of another, tied with a cloth till the roots develop, and when the roots develop, they grow into a new plant. And here one plant may be plant A and other may be plant B, the scion and the stalk. And the last one is tissue culture. In tissue culture, the growing parts of the plant, as you know, meristematic tissue is found in the growing parts of the plant. A part of the tissue is taken from there and they are grown in the laboratory. Once this tissue takes the shape of a plant, they are removed and grown in the field for its betterment. These we usually find in plants like paddy or chili or tomato.